Our brains make decisions constantly throughout our day. Everything from what to eat for breakfast to which route to take to work. When our brains make decisions, we usually use a goal-directed strategy. Goal-directed behaviors require us to think to execute them. When we're hungry, we open the fridge and take stock of what we have. Then we choose something based on a number of factors. Maybe what we ate previously in the week, what's about to expire, or maybe what our doctor told us we should eat more or less of. You can imagine that this takes up a lot of brain resources because we have to consider all the possible outcomes of our actions and then choose accordingly. So our brain counters this with a more reflexive strategy called habits. Once we have a handle on a behavior, our brain shifts it over to our habit system to run on autopilot. So back to my example, you may find something that you like to eat in the morning, and if it's quick and easy, you may start to eat it every day. That way, your sleepy brain doesn't need to make that decision, and you can reallocate those cognitive resources to other more important decisions. In this sense, habits are a really valuable part of our behavior, and balancing goal-directed actions with these habits allows us to make both adaptive and efficient decisions. But over-reliance on habits can become problematic. When our environmental or motivational contexts change, we need to be able to shift back to our goal-directed strategy to reassess and possibly choose a new action. So an early or more inflexible transition to habits can actually be pathological. And an over-reliance on these maladaptive habits is actually an endophenotype or an underlying characteristic of a number of psychiatric conditions, ranging from things like addiction to anxiety, autism, obsessive-compulsive disorder, and even post-traumatic stress disorder. And together, these conditions affect over 1 billion people worldwide. So how do habits get to this point where they become problematic? We've learned there are some factors that tip this balance between goal-directed actions and habits. One of those factors is previous exposure to chronic stress, and stress makes us rely more heavily on habits. Many of us find ourselves engaging in unhealthy habits during stressful periods, things like overeating or drugs or alcohol use. This highlights the strong relationship between stress and habits, and more broadly, the effects of emotion on decision-making. Now, personally, I understand firsthand the effects of stress on habits. In college, I juggled a number of part-time jobs and a Division I sport, so I understand how emotions can affect all of our behavior. Even though I started my scientific career studying cancer biology, this is actually what drove me to switch to neuroscience in graduate school. And now it's brought me to this really interesting question that I'm excited to answer, which is whether stress can make us more vulnerable to addiction and other psychiatric conditions by making our brains quicker to develop habits. If this is the case, it could transform our approach to treating these psychiatric conditions. But first, we have to understand what brain mechanisms to target. While we know what brain regions control goal-directed actions and habits, we know very little about how stress affects these regions and their connections. My goal is to find the specific neural mechanism that allows stress to promote habits so that we can improve our treatment approaches for conditions where maladaptive habits are problematic, like substance use disorders. To do this, I train mice on a behavioral task where they have to press a lever to get a food reward. Now, you may be wondering, how can we learn about human behavior from studying mice? And actually, many of the regions in the human brain are also present in mice, as well as rats and non-human primates. And we've learned a lot about how human behavior is controlled by studying these same processes in rodents. In fact, the same task I use in my mice is also used in human behavioral studies of habits, as well as diagnosing maladaptive habits in patient populations. This allows us to uncover how stress hijacks our brain to promote habits prematurely. Specifically, I'm looking at connections between the amygdala, a region that's really important for processing emotional information, with the dorsal striatum, a region that's critical for controlling this balance between actions and habits. And now, new state-of-the-art technology allows us to visualize individual brain cell activity in our mice while they freely perform our behavioral task. Then we can turn that activity on and off to see whether it alleviates or promotes premature habits. Understanding how connections between the amygdala and the dorsal striatum control behavior normally and after stress is critical to understanding how stress promotes habits. And that will lay the foundation for improving treatments for conditions like addiction and other psychiatric disorders that are marked by maladaptive habits. This will also lay the foundation for my future lab's research, which will focus on drug-seeking habits specifically and how cues from the environment affect this process.